Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I am Hasan Ali from Chand Bagh School, grade 12 and 13 chemistry teacher. Today, students, our topic of discussion is Hess's cycle correlating lattice energy, enthalpy of solution and enthalpy of hydration. So, this is a new type of Hess's cycle that is asked within the paper. And through this cycle, we have to calculate any one of the energies that are present within the Hess's cycle. So, how the question is asked within the paper, I have taken the example of silver chloride. The examiner was asking, calculate the enthalpy of solution of silver chloride if lattice energy of silver chloride is plus 905 kilojoule per mole, enthalpy of hydration of chloride ion is minus 364 kilojoule per mole, enthalpy of hydration of silver positive is minus 464 kilojoule per mole. So, for the purpose of the calculation of the enthalpy of solution of silver chloride, first of all, we have to draw the Hess's cycle. How the Hess's cycle is drawn? I've given you the example of silver chloride. Here it is the Hess's cycle that is correlated with the silver chloride. Here you can see that there are two types of arrows within the diagram. One is black arrow and the other ones are green arrows. The black arrow is representing the direct path, while the green arrows are representing the indirect path. In the first process, that is, silver chloride is dissolved in water to form silver positive ions and chloride negative ions. And the process of dissolving one mole of silver chloride in the water, it is known as dissolution, and the enthalpy change that takes place in this process is known as enthalpy of solution. Here the enthalpy of solution of silver chloride is represented by delta H3. While for the indirect process, the green arrows are here that are representing the indirect process. In the indirect process, the first step is the conversion of silver chloride into silver positive gaseous ions and chloride negative gaseous ions. For the conversion of one mole of silver chloride into its gaseous ions, the enthalpy change that takes place is known as lattice energy or lattice dissociation enthalpy. This is represented by delta H1. Here its value is plus 905 kilojoule per mole as given per in the question. While in the second process, that is our delta H2, what is happening? We are hydrating the silver positive ions and chloride negative ions within the water. So delta H2 is here representing two enthalpies. That is enthalpy of hydration of silver positive ion, that is minus 464 kilojoule per mole, and enthalpy of hydration of chloride ion, that is minus 364 kilojoule per mole. So students, this is how you are to draw the Hess's cycle for the enthalpy of solution calculation. Now coming for the calculation part, in the calculation part, we know direct route is equal to indirect route. Here the direct route is represented by delta H3, that is equivalent to delta H1 plus delta H2. Here delta H1 plus and delta H2 are representing the indirect route enthalpies. Delta H3, what is delta H3? Delta H3 is delta H solution of silver chloride. Delta H1 is lattice energy of silver chloride. Delta H2 is basically composed of two enthalpies, that is enthalpy of hydration of chloride ion and enthalpy of hydration of silver positive ion. By putting the values, we are able to calculate the enthalpy of solution. Lattice energy comes out to be 905 kilojoule per mole, that is given within the question. Hydration enthalpy of chloride ion is minus 364 kilojoule per mole, that is also given within the question. Hydration enthalpy of silver positive ion is also given within the question, that is minus 464 kilojoule per mole. So by putting the values, we are able to get a value that is plus 77 kilojoule per mole. This means that the delta H solution of the silver chloride is an endothermic process. As we have already known that in the previous video, I have discussed that the enthalpy of solution could be positive or negative depending on the ionic species that is to be dissolved within the water. In this case, for the silver chloride, the enthalpy of solution is endothermic, and that is plus 77 kilojoule per mole. Students, Hopefully, you are able to understand the concept of the Hess's cycle related to enthalpy of solution. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.